How Black Lives Matter is killing Americans. That is the subject of this evening's Talking Points memo. First, the stats, and they are stunning. Since the Ferguson chaos, murders in the USA's 50 largest cities are up close to 17%, and much higher in cities with large black populations. In Chicago, for example, this year alone, shootings up around 80%. Why? Because the Chicago police have stopping suspicious people.
Well, folks, that was Bill O'Reilly last night on Fox News on the O'Reilly Factor, blaming Black Lives Matter for crime going up. You know what this reminds me of? This reminds me of folks blaming women for rape because they actually wear a skirt. See, what's interesting here is Bill O'Reilly won't call the cops out for not doing their job. What he's going to do is call out Black Lives Matter, the group that's actually holding cops accountable for not doing their job. See, what you're experiencing here, folks, is a perfect example of constantly wanting to shift the conversation away from the real cause, and that is, let's actually blame those who are fighting the system. But you know what's interesting, Bill? I noticed you didn't say jack about the cops in Chicago who lied on the stand in countless cases broken by the Chicago Tribune. I noticed you didn't deal with that. I noticed you haven't called out the cops who erased the video at the Burger King in the Laquan McDonald case. I noticed, Bill, that you won't say anything and apologize to Black Lives Matter for accusing them of causing the cop to be killed in Texas when they had nothing to do with it. That was simply some deranged man. Folks, I need y'all to understand here. Bill O'Reilly has the largest watch show on cable news. Bill O'Reilly is largely talking to a white audience, an older white audience. Bill O'Reilly is not interested in actual facts. In fact, Bill O'Reilly is not interested in a real debate. This is the same guy who said on his show that he'll gladly debate anybody on his show who defends Black Lives Matter. I volunteered. My people called Bill's people. They said, we'll take it to Bill. Bill is still scared. In fact, I even was told that the Fox News PR people called a reporter who wrote about that and said, how dare you write about Roland Martin talking about Bill O'Reilly? Well, guess what, Bill? I'm talking about your sorry behind again. For you to continue to attack Black Lives Matter for holding cops accountable is shameful because folks like you and Sheriff David Clark and Sean Hannity, y'all don't want cops held accountable because you make excuses for them. It'd be different if you actually covered the examples of cops doing wrong. It'd be different if you hold them accountable. But see, you don't do that. Every time there's an example, especially in Chicago, you love to talk about what's happening, killing on the streets, which is important. But I've also noticed you never left your comfortable studio to go to Chicago. And you never talked about the Holman facility where they were holding suspects and not telling their lawyers. How have you just ignored those stories since you love talking about Chicago? The reality is this. Black Lives Matter has forced a level of accountability in America dealing with police that we have never seen. And the people to blame for crime going up are these sorry cops who don't want to do their job, but they want to draw their paychecks and they want their pension. They're the ones who are not doing their jobs. They're the ones who should be patrolling. And I'll say this, if you're a cop doing stuff right, you shouldn't be afraid if you're caught on videotape. Because you know what? You say it doesn't matter. But tell me this, Bill, did you do a story the other day on a cop who punched a woman who was simply sitting down with her cell phone? I noticed you never do any of those stories because you say those are just a few bad apples, except when we see video after video after video after video. I guess at Fox News, y'all don't have the capacity to see those videos. You must have a cop filter block on your internet that prevents you from actually seeing the videos that we often show on this show. And I said it point blank. Every time you call out Black Lives Matter and you're wrong, I'm gonna check you, Bill, because in this case, you're a flat out liar. And I'll say it again, if you want a debate, call me. Pick the day, pick the time, pick the location, and I'll be there. I'll pay my own way. But the reality is, you don't want that conversation because you don't want your viewers to actually be exposed to facts. What you want to do is keep blaming Black Lives Matter for cops who are doing wrong. Look at my panel here. What bothers me again is the lack of accountability.
No, I mean, I gotta breathe, Roland. I feel like
the collection plate should be handed around to everybody. Look, what gets me about Bill and a lot of other right-wing people about this is they love the idea of government accountability when it comes to teachers or when it comes to Congress or when it comes to anybody else
when
who works for the government.
Bureaucrats.
Exactly.
Or when it comes to TSA.
Exactly. Everybody's got to be held accountable in the government except for cops. Except for some reason, police officers are no longer government employees who are just taking a check.
They're these exalted beings who you can't say anything about, and you must just show love and appreciation at all times.
And I've said this all along. If you had a local hospital that was repeatedly getting in trouble for children dying in the hospital, if you had a school system where everybody was getting in trouble every other year for kids getting beat up or hurt, they would order the firing of every teacher and every single doctor in that school. But for some reason, when cops kill black people all the time, suddenly, they can't be held accountable. It's ridiculous.
Also, I dare Bill O'Reilly to have Ryan and his mother on.
Oh, he won't.
And call out the cop who arrested him for free milk.
Absolutely.
But you know what?
Not.
The belief is, the serious side of this is that there is a belief in this country that black people are demons and brutes and violent. And that white people have to be protected from us, and that's what they see the police doing.
Oh, he described it. This subculture happening among African Americans and the killings, but he won't deal with poverty.
He
won't deal with any of those issues, but it's just, oh no, there's this. What he's trying to do is essentially say there's this defect in black people.
Exactly.
That, oh my God, this explains what's going on.
We must
even though O'Reilly would not say on his show that of the cops killed this year, mostly killed by whites.
You know, it's the same story because we don't say an immigration problem that our trade policies are the reason their country is paying them 5 cents an hour. We're not saying we set up a system by which you're going to want to run from your country. We never want to deal with the detail, as Roland's saying. But Roland, when Bill O'Reilly invites you on the show, when he does, I'm having a watch party. Everybody bring wine and popcorn.
I mean, the whole, you know. Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, Bill is and has always been very good at playing the ratings game. He knows his audience
and
like that.
And playing the race call. Right?
Oh, yeah.
And he plays
knows
the race
his audience
right.
very
and
well.
I'm not calling him a racist. Does he play? Oh, I got called a racist. No.
No.
But you played a race card.
What he's doing is what you talked about, Roland, which is everyone's doing it. There's displacing the conversation as if people of color and black lives in particular are not entitled to question police because there is crime in some neighborhoods and there is murder rate in some neighborhoods and some communities. Therefore, you cannot walk and chew gum at the same time.
Right.
But the fact of the matter is the police have largely operated on the Supreme Court's, you know, good graces, giving them authority to make decisions they want to and not be checked unless there's some, you know, grotesque thing that's happened. And so now what we're seeing is, listen, officers, you are being held the same you've always been held to, but now there is an actual magnifying glass on you.
And I'm going to say this. To me, because it's the same thing as Trump, I don't care if you're a racist in your heart or you just played a racist, it's just as bad, okay? If you're promoting dishonesty and it's troped and it's seeping, it's dripping with this sort of racial invective and the same BS that we've all dealt with for the last 400 years in this country, it's just as bad. This is a life and death issue here. This isn't just a matter of culture. This isn't just a matter of behavior. People are dying. That young man who was just here a couple of minutes ago, who knows what could have happened if his mother didn't work in the school system. Right. If she had worked at a job where we couldn't get. These are life and death issues, and they treat it as racist.
And what about the fact that the same thing, this young man, that's a traumatic experience.
Yes.
Right.
Being at lunch,
exactly.
And you going back and get some milk, and then now you got some cuffs on you. But again, but see, Bill won't defend him.
No.
See, Bill won't defend him.
Right.
See, he'll ignore that story, won't call that cop
because
out.
Because Bill doesn't relate to that child as being a child. There's nothing in his heart that would love that child. It's true about Martin. That jury could not see that as their own child.
Or Tamir.
You know, or Tamir.
The bottom line is here.
Right.
I am not going to stand silent and continue this game and not hold cops accountable. And I would say for the cops who refuse to do their job because of this whole issue of I'm afraid after Ferguson, you know what? Go find a new job. Ooh. Go somewhere else, and we will happily go hire new cops. We have no problem doing it. Final comment.
If your problem, officers, is that you don't want to be accountable for following the law, then you should not be in law enforcement where you expect people to follow the law.
All right, hey, Bill, you got the number. You want to roll? Let's roll.
I'm a puppy.
Anytime, any day. But see, if you got guts, you'll call me. But a wimp, somebody who's scared, somebody who wants to run from the truth, they'll keep hiding.
Well,
you're supposed to be the man.
Wow.
You're supposed to want to debate anybody. Holler at a brother. Anytime. Any day.
Can we take this time?
I'm here. Coming up, we'll talk about the Affordable Care Act.